So continuing on here at court two in this evening session on day two, men's singles from Group A, Shi Yuqi taking on Anthony Sinisuka Ginting. That's where we stand in Group A. All players have played their first game, and it's just Shi Yuqi that has the flawless record with that two straight games win over Victor Axelsen. Everybody else has dropped at least one game. Anthony Sinisuka Ginting dropping one against Kodai Nairoka. So ideally, Ginting is hoping to come through with a straight games win here just to consolidate his position. As for Shi Yuqi, if he can pull off a straight games win here, well, that's qualification immediately. Not just based on the two wins, but based on the fact that he's going to have a plus four games difference. Really had the crowd behind him yesterday as he played one of the best games, or best matches, against the great Dane, Victor Axelsen. And as for Anthony Sinisuka Ginting, he looked almost down and out in the third decider against Kodai Narioka, but then a good burst of energy right at the end, and he made it through the gates. 10-21, 21-10, 21-18 in the end. Very close match for Shi Yuqi, 21-19, 21-19, score symmetry against Victor Axelsen. This is going to be an absolute classic. But then, of course, you could say that about every single match at the HSBC BWF World Tour Finals. The best of the best, all the big names, all the big games. World number seven taking on the world number four. Shi Yuqi with an 8-1, there you go. 8-1 head-to-head lead last time they met at the Sudirman Cup. And she won that 22-20, 21-14. It's all set up for him. He's won the tournament before, of course, Shi Yuqi. Back in 2018, only Chinese men's singles player to have lifted the trophy. So looking for his second, of course, Ginting, a finalist in 2019 and 2022. Both really, really competent and capable players. And no stranger to the big occasion. For Shi Yuqi, well, he was 27 years old now, born Jiangsu. Semi-finalist in Denmark, semi-finalist at the China Open, the Career Open, runner-up at the All England. There was that great all-Chinese All England final. Semi-finalist at the Thai Masters, the Indonesia Masters, and also runner-up at the recent Japan Masters. And Anthony Ginting, as I said, finalist in 2019, 2022. He would love to get his first title, make it to the final here this year. All-rounder, can't really fault him in this game. Born in Cimahi, Indonesia, currently ranked fourth, has been as high as two, and that was January of this year. Semi-finalist at the Hong Kong Open, runner-up at the Indonesian Open, his home open, of course. Won the Singapore Open, and semi-finalist right at the start of the year at the India Open. He looks like he's going to be starting Ginting from the driftiest side of the court. Of course, singles, that can be quite the factor.
Ready to play.
It's good start from both of them. And they wouldn't want to wreck that by getting a loss here in their second game. Consolidation is what it's all about, but somebody has to lose. There's our umpire, Dhiraj Gunedri. Joined by our service judge, Trish Gubb. And you can already hear the crowd getting behind Chi. She hasn't even hit a shuttle yet. Well, actually, the crowd might just be rooting for Zheng Shiwei and Huang Yaosheng, who are actually in action on court one right now. There's Henry Saputra, the
ladies and gentlemen,
singles coach,
Chi Yuqi, China. And on my left, Anthony Sinisuka Ginting, Indonesia.
Settle back, people.
Anthony Sinisuka Ginting to serve level.
Because this is going to be an absolute cracker of a match.
Service over, one, love.
From Ginting, he's on the board.
Service over, one, two.
Such a tough group that they are in. And you know, Narioka and Axelsen are going to come out all guns blazing. Their next match. Be later on today. Again, from Ginting, he started brightly. From Ginting, but even better reaction from Yuqi. Lightest of touches, but kept his composure. 3-4. Yeah. great pickup from Yuchi. Oh, he's pushed that wide. Ginting was in control. Just couldn't finish it off. Absolutely nothing between them right now, but I have to say that Ginting seems to be building his rallies a little bit better. It's hard to say though. Just that finishing touch hasn't been working for him. Remember, he is playing from the breezier side of the court. Again, catches that wind.
6-4.
It's the first 2-point lead. Two mistakes now creeping in.
7-4.
Almost blocked that, Ginting.
Service over, 5-8.
Ginting actually picked up his first title of the year at the Asian Championships. Beating Lo Kan Yew of Singapore in the final, straight games. That was Indonesia's first men's singles title since Taufik Hidayat in 2007. It's one of the many glittering points of 2023.
6-8.
Oh, that's great.
7-8.
Oh, that's good resilience from Ginting. He's clawed back that 4-point lead.
Seven.
Just need to notice coach immediately noting down. Don't drop serves at key points in matches, maybe. great bit of deception from Ginting. Off the return. He actually touched the net there. He's going to be called up on it. So the slightest, tiniest errors, and Shi Yuqi is on the brink of the mid-game interval break. Ginting. Oh, that's wide, and it looks suspiciously like it caught the wind.
11,
there is a bit of right to left, sideways drift. So it's 11-7 at the break. So,
11,
court.
7.
Second phase of game one.
Play.
Watch a return from Ginting. Again. Oh, that's just sublime. That's incredible.
That's over.
If Shi Yuqi had won that point, well, there would have been great platform for debate, because that was some incredible play by Anthony Sinisuka Ginting. If ever you had to say that somebody deserved a point, that would be that one. That's wide.
That's over. 12, 8.
So remember, Shi Yuqi with the flawless record so far in Group 8. No games dropped. Anthony Ginting, one game dropped against Narioka. But both players sitting pretty, one and two, Group A. That's where you want to be. It's beautiful. Chi-chi. Wow. Straight down the line.
Eight.
Day two Thursday has already seen some high-profile casualties, I can tell you that. Hanyue on two losses. Aaron Chan, Sowu Yik in men's doubles.
40.
Two losses. Between Mel Arn, as we said, on two losses. Of course, in the women's doubles, sadly, Mayu Matsumoto and Okana Nagahara had to withdraw
8.
Due to an eye injury to Nagahara. We do wish her a speedy recovery. Kitty Tarakun and Pajongjai also in Group B, two losses. And Kim So-young and Kong Hee-young, which is surprising, two losses for them, eliminated. Scoreline for Xu Chi, 16-8. Combination of a few errors and some great winners from him.
3-1.
That's a beautiful shot too.
17-8.
Out.
Service over. 9-17. Chi Yuchi challenge goal out. Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining.
17-3-5.
So 17-10. Things looking good for Xu Chi to keep his flawless record.
17.
Very wide.
19-10.
It's just
that's over. 11.
And he gets the service 19. Back, but it's looking increasingly likely that Xu Chi is going to seal this first game. 19. Back going wide. That is.
That's over. 20. Game point.
9 11. Game points. So, 21-11 in 19 minutes.
First game won by Chi Chi, 21-11.
He's looking good here.
Dia kan udah siap terus nih mau serangan kamu kan. Sebelum kamu tahu, kamu tetap kontrol. Nembaknya buat udah kesempatan aja. Kalau enggak turun, kamu suka dia enggak sabar. Dia yang mau menyerang kamu. Yang penting kamu siap nih. Ya, dari defense-nya baru kamu putar serang. Jangan ngumpan, dia mau pegang net terus tuh. Supaya kamu enggak enak. Dia mau coba mau tipis-tipis mana? Kamu panjang ya, belokin, kamu dorong lagi. Udah dia nggak sabar. Tahan aja udah, gitu ya. Yang penting ada kesempatan.
Lah, jadi Fa Jie Fa 的落点呢变化非常好的，然后落点的话让它清楚，它没用的，对吧？然后就是底线，你看控制一下，就你说你看感觉一下，不要放，然后以后自己感觉一下，其他的都没有问题，啊，保持住精力啊。
Satu, tahan, tahan lagi, ya, come on, bisa.
So back on court for game two. And Anthony Sinisuka has conceded another game in terms of the table.
Second game, love all.
Now she has to deal with that fast shuttle at the end of that side of the court. Early days, but I have to say that Ginting has to be on point for the second game. Oh, that's nice. That's very nice from Ginting. Push into the corner.
Two, one.
And again, just rolling forward. Very much what he did against Kodai Narioka, actually. Started pushing the points. Really moving forward and cutting down that response time. Position for Xiu Qi to try and reply. He's finding a good lot of value in the backcourt now. Ginting racing off to a 5-1 lead.
Five.
Just couldn't get there in time.
Five.
Placement again, and that's what's really led to this lead. Ginting really thinking about where he wants that shuttle to end up. He's been putting it in increasingly difficult positions, but she achieves a return. That's a wonderful cross court from Chiu Chi. Really picked that out of the air well.
Three, eight. Wonderful, wonderful. Ginting.
So that early control that Ginting was showing in this second game eroded a bit by wonderful returns by Chiu Chi, still in control. Let's see if Chiu Chi can overturn this 5-point deficit. Keep that intact record. As I said, in such a difficult group, if you can have an intact game difference of plus 4, that's 2 straight games wins. Well, that's really going to help you when it gets through day 3. The reason we're saying that's why. The reason we're saying that is, we just can't tell which way Marioka Axelsen's going to go, and that's the next match coming up. Or should be on court 1, I think. Yes, it is, in fact. It's going to be the next match up on court 1 after the mixed doubles now. Out.
Dead. Green.
So 11-3, and Ginting has regained that good control as we hit the second mid-game interval. Sinisuka back on court for part two of game two.
11-3, play.
Good little burst from Ginting just before that interval. And he's now looking in a very good position to take game two. If he can hold his nerve, that's a good
12,
shot fired in.
3.
Oh, class from Ginting. Team 3 and the longest rally of the match so far. With the serve. Good flurry of points here. Do wonders for his confidence. He's struggling. Respite from the relentless pressure that Ginting's been putting on. And it continues. Left that well.
16-4.
Well, I think the dreams of that perfect record are very quickly falling away for Shiichi. And all I can say is, if Ginting does take this game, he looks like he will, then Group A is very much more wide open. nice.
84.
Ginting showing his true prowess. Absolutely commanding second game. In no challenge coming.
Sinisuka, 5-90.
So 15 game points for Anthony Sinisuka Ginting. That's one save, but really the odds stacked against Chiu Chi.
20.
I'm going to stick my neck out. I don't have to stick it out that far to say that we're going to get a third and deciding game here in the men's singles. Really isn't that much of a prediction at 26, I guess you could say. What a comeback it would be if Chiu Chi could pull this back. Make headlines all around the world. And that's gone long. That's another one saved.
7-20.
And that's, well, a challenge coming from there. Just out. I actually think that was out. Oh, it's on the line. And that's fantastic. Right down the middle, too.
Game.
So, 21-7. And we're going
second
to a decider.
Game won by Anthony Sinisuka Ginting, 21-7. One game over.
Just as I said, now no player in Group A has a flawless record.
Thank you.
Final game. Play.
So here we go. Third final deciding game. That's nice. So, Ginting.
One love.
Two people, I can tell you, will be very happy that this has gone to a decider, and that is, of course, Daxison and Kodai Narioka. Both of them will be watching this match simply because the mixed doubles on court one, absolutely epic affair between Kim Jong. Kim Won-ho and Jong Na-eun, and Cheng Shi-wei and Huang Yashong has gone to a third game. All out attack from Ginting. Better side of the court that Yu Qi's playing from. So he's going to be a bit frustrated that he hasn't found his range. Again, Anthony Ginting doing exactly what he did against Kodai, just really rushing forward. Increasing the tempo of the point. He was in the third and deciding game. He won that match against Narioka.
Double over, 1-4. It's over. 5-1.
And still errors creeping in.
It's over.
2-5. Looking a little bit incredulous at that shot. I don't think he expected that. Pinpoint.
Double over. 6-2.
Such fluid action on the jump. From Yu Qi.
That's over. 3-6.
Thank you. rather lovely cross court from Xu Chi.
4-6.
So 6-4. He's done well to bridge that gap. Couple of mistakes.
Four.
Ginting back in control.
Nine. Four.
That was an ambitious clear, though, on the backhand side. Points for effort.
5-9.
Or at least praise for the effort. Point going to Xu Chi, but look how close this was. Reflex return. Has been said on many an occasion, he's not the tallest player, Anthony Sinisuka Ginting, especially when compared to some of the other men's singles players.
Play.
It's 5'7", Anthony Sinisuka Ginting. Xu Chi is 6 foot, Jackson of course big as well, but what he lacks in those extra inches,
five.
He has in speed of court coverage, really gets around well. Now 1 point away from the third and final mid-game interval. It's very delicate. Oh. The pick is spot. 11-5.
11-5.
So here we go.
Play.
The most important phase of play. Second part of game three. That's a great Lofton winner into. to the corner.
That's over. 6-11.
Ideal situation if she could hold Ginting at 11. Claw that back. Affair. Eye off the shuttle and misses a sitter. Points.
No.
Wasn't too bad. He managed to cut into that lead a bit. Ginting now on his favoured side of the court. Settles himself. That's wide. And looking at Chi's body language, he's not too happy with these mistakes that he's making. Serve here could put him beyond reach. That's worked out very well for Shiuchi.
15-10.
Just a look of resignation on Shiuchi's face. He's certainly putting his full effort in, just not Right, getting the breaks he needs.
That's over. 11-15.
And every time it looks like Ginting's going to tear away. And he's subject to an error as well.
That's over. 16-11.
Six-point lead, needs four. As I said, this result by both of these players that have already got one win, it's going to be great for Ginting, of course, to get on to two wins. But by taking it to three, it does leave a little bit of a crack open for Naraoka and
17.
Victor Axelsen, should they, of course, win their final two games. Might come down to the nature of how they win them. So Victor and Kodai up on court one next. And Kodai will play Shiyuchi tomorrow. And Victor will play Ginting tomorrow. That will bring an end to Group A. Gone into the third day.
Play.
He's pushed that long. Just can't find the range.
70.
Himself well, Ginting. That's gone long as well. So Shiyuchi edges closer. Umpire says it's okay.
That's over. 18.
And he gets
14.
His important 18th point. Do it as quickly as possible. Oh, a wonderful angle he found. Defense, but then almost that transitional block. That was great. And he blocks it there. And that fantastic snatched winner. What an important point that was. Points back now.
18.
The crowd here behind him. Very careful about where he was leaving 19, that shuffle.
16.
19-16.
Chinese match point 60.
So, four match points for Ginting to get that consolidating second win, even though he's dropped another game. That's the most important fact. But not yet.
17-20.
Just past the hour mark. Oh, he's all over the place, Ginting. Recovers. And it's a glorious cross-court winner. He takes the win in 62 minutes. So he will sit atop of Group A. Xu Chi gets a loss to add to his win. And now all eyes will be on court one and how that match goes between Victor Axelsen and Kodai Narioka. Meanwhile, job done for Anthony Sinisuka Ginting, or at least the best he could do given the circumstances. There's confirmation of it, 11-21, 21-7, 21-17, 62 minutes. And Anthony Sinisuka Ginting gets his second win of the week. Up next, it's the mixed doubles. Yuta Watanabe and Arisa Higashino. Great performers yesterday. They'll be looking for their second win, and it's a must-win tie for Chen Tangji and Togi Wee. It's coming up next. Don't go anywhere. So as we continue on here on session two, court two, day two, it's the mixed doubles. Yuta Watanabe and Arisa Higashino with one win under the belt against the Malaysians Cheng Tangji and To Iwi, looking for their first win of the week. And as you can see, if you look at Group A, the mixed doubles,